I'm here with boxing star Luis Cuba Arias. How was it like to be up there on stage today? Lucas Matisse, Danny Garcia.
It was fun. Let's just say that it was fun. It's a blessing, you know. I'm just glad to be a part of such a big event. It was a very funny and exciting press conference. And just to show you what type of event this is. It's sold out, and it's about to be great. It's about to be history.
Luis, let's walk around the room for a second. See who else is here from the TNT team. I saw Andrew Tabiti in the corner. Yeah. Let's go talk really quick and see.
You want to talk to Tabiti?
Yeah, let's see what people are doing right now.
The next to AB.
What do you think about AB and Danny Garcia together right
AB
here?
AB always balling. Swift attractions.
Swift, what do you think about Luis Cuba Arias?
Boom right here, man. He's been around for a minute.
Since amateurs.
Yeah, so.
USA's.
Broner says.
I'm happy people like him get the opportunity. I'm saying it's because you know how the posse this morning is. So.
Broner said you're his brother.
Yeah, no, that way. Yeah, we're from.
Well, he's already.
Can't tell the resemblance.
We're my brother from another.
You can't tell the resemblance.
So what do you say about his fight on Matisse?
Like I told everybody else, I've been knowing him since amateurs, you know, and he can box. A lot of people don't even know that, but this is a perfect opportunity for him to display his boxing abilities. You know, Lucas is strong, but, I mean, who isn't? You know, what's going to happen once Danny hits him? What's going to happen when he getting hit with both sides?
Like I said before,
both shots.
Like I said before, if all you had to be was strong to win a championship, he would have been a champion.
Arnold Schwarzenegger would have been
a champion. Yeah.
Hey, okay, what do you say about Angel Garcia, speech writer for Barack Obama?
Yeah, I think so. I think he needs to get his own show.
I told him.
He needs to get his own. They need to boost him up, man. That guy's
like
a character.
New Jerry Springer.
He's funny.
All right, Andrew Tabiti in the house. Tell us about him right here.
This Andrew Tabiti, man.
He's
I've known him from the amateurs as well.
Really?
Heavyweight upcoming, you know.
What was he like in amateurs?
It was good, you know. I saw him fight. You know, he went to the USA's. He's medaled. He's, you know, he's made his mark in the amateur days. And now it's time for both of us to make our mark in the professionals.
What do you think about him?
He's a good fighter. You know, I see him going real far. The next world champion.
Have you seen him spar Floyd yet?
Oh, yeah.
What's that like when Luis Cuba Arias and Floyd Mayweather are in the ring?
He always gives people a hard time. Anybody I see him on spar. You know what I'm saying? He gives everybody a hard time. He comes to fight.
That's right.
He's a straight dog.
Do you think Luis, he hasn't accomplished enough to be as cocky and arrogant as he is in the gym?
He big, so yeah, you gotta let him do what he wanted to do. You know, them heavyweights, you can't really tell him too much.
We got a new TNT star over here. Who's here right now?
KO Bellows.
Yes, sir.
KO.
Yes, sir.
What do you think about him?
KO. That's all you need to know. That boy come to work, come to put your lights out, you know, and he's a great guy, man. I'm glad to be part of the team.
All three of you are fighting September 14 in the biggest boxing card. What's it like to say, hey, I'm fighting on that card? Like, tweet it, Facebook it. What are people telling you guys?
It's a blessing. It's historic. And like I said, who better to do it with than my boys Cuba and Drew? You know what I'm saying? They some animals. We doghouse veterans. You know what I'm saying? So you can always come get that work. We always willing to give it out.
Hey,
you know
what I'm saying? Linnell, Andrew's in your spot for this fight. Last card with Guerrero. You open up the show. Yeah. Tabiti's doing this one. Any advice for him?
Oh, no. He's going to go out there and put the smoke on that boy. Then I'm going to follow him up. Then Cuba going to follow it up. And this is going to be all victorious the whole night, baby. Yes, damn me. Yeah.
Okay. Last time I talked to you guys in the gym, you all told me Mayweather knocks out Canelo. And you said 6 rounds or 5 rounds. What's your prediction now with just the fight?
I mean, a little closer. Just the later rounds. I still got him stopping him. I just don't. To say six, I mean, that's like trying to hit the nail on the head, you know. But I'm saying, after six, he's subject to go. Anytime after
it's
six.
It's going, I think Floyd going to get him in the later rounds. He's going to really get him later.
Yeah, I mean, if anybody gets stopped, it'll be Canelo. But I think Canelo's going to have too many fans screaming. It's going to be too big of a scene for him to just give up and get stopped. So unless Floyd puts him down and out, I see him just having too much pride to quit. But I see him getting whooped for 12 rounds.
You know what's funny? You guys are in a good mood and you have your weigh-in tomorrow. And usually fighters before weigh-in are antsy. They're in a bad mood because they're trying to lose the last half pound. How come you guys are so happy right now?
This ain't our first dance. Like you said, we just coming off the make course. So, I mean, this ain't nothing but another day in the gym as far as we're concerned.
Make the weight early, you ain't got to make it the day before.
Hard work and dedication. This ain't nothing but another day for us.
How is it when you guys all work together? Who gets the best of who in the sparring?
I ain't no best of best because, I mean, it's a learning thing, but we awesome dogs. I ain't gonna never cut a short on that. We all get in there. We do what we do. We all bring our own intensity to the sport, to the sparring, so he can't have a bad day if he in there doing something. If I'm in there doing something and we have different styles, I mean, we both had a good day. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. We don't even mess with this dude.
You're too big, man. You know what I asked him yesterday? I said, how'd you get so buff? He said, I was just born buff.
Yeah. He was.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, when he was in the amateurs, he was this buff.
Yeah, yeah. As you can see, his shirt looked like it's on the hanger right now. On the hanger right now.
Oh, man. So the power is just something else.
Yeah, and the power, no, the speed. The power is a plus, but the speed, you shouldn't be that fast and be that big. That's just my personal opinion.
It's cheating.
Yeah, definitely.
What does it take to be part of TMT? Is there an initiation? How did you guys all get in? What does it take to be part of it?
He worked hard. I definitely work hard. So, I mean, hard work and dedication is the motto. So, we just happen to be in the right place at the right time when we was exercising our hard work and dedication. So, it's just a blessing.
And with Andrew, I think it involved the live chicken and some tequila, too, right?
Oh, man. No.
Why?
No. Whoa. Slow down.
Okay, last thing. One sentence about Floyd Mayweather, working with him, being on his promotional card.
Man, it's a blessing. Like I said, a lot of people don't get to know Floyd Mayweather, the person. They just know Floyd Mayweather, the entertainer, the fighter, the TV Floyd. We had an opportunity to meet Floyd and talk to him as a person. And you know, he's real down to earth. He's a real cool person, you know, and he's helpful. You know, he helps so many people. He changes people's lives every day, whether it's through a tip, you know, overly tipping somebody, or through just whatever. Any phone call that he gets and he feels like he can help, he's always helping. So it's been a blessing and it's been a great opportunity. And I just, you know, thank God for it.
Definitely. I mean, I feel that I'm on the same lines. I feel the exact same way. My fault to interrupt you, bro. But nah, he definitely he changed our life.
Hey, hold on.
You can't punch me. I got to fight. No, he definitely changed all our lives. He changes everybody's life who he around. This is what people don't know. Like you say, down to earth. He constantly calling, checking on us. You know what I'm saying? He's in the gym giving us reason to keep on grinding, to grind harder. So, I mean, with that being said, I mean, he is a blessing. You know what I'm saying? We're blessed, but he is the blessing himself. And like I said, for those that don't know, man, he does his thing. He's a positive role model. He's a good family man, father. You know what I mean? He's just a great person to be around, man.
Yeah, people got to understand the positive Floyd. You know, he feeds a lot of people's families. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
He's a blessing. So, he'd be in position if he wasn't famous.
Exactly. Cool. At KOBellows on Twitter and Instagram.
At KOBellows on Instagram, but Linnell Bellows on Instagram. I mean, on Twitter and Facebook.
You tell them what tell I told you.
It's too complicated, man. You gotta make it easy.
Make the same for both.
Make it simple.
KOBellows Instagram and Linnell Bellows Twitter, baby.
And Andrew Tabiti with a T I N N. Andrew Tabiti.
Andrew Tabiti, yep. With an I at the I at the end, yep.
And Luis Cuba Arias, both on Twitter and Instagram.
There you go, simple.
And it works too.
I still got followers.
There you have it. Stay tuned. Visitreport.com and Melissa Back reporting.